inspiration. For over 50 years, the revolutionary force in sports entertainment.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Ambassador coming at you from Tampa, Florida for Wrestling Classics' first ever pay-per-view. We're ready for all the action, as there is no less than four championship titles on the line right here tonight in Tampa, Florida. Wrestling Classic presents to you Overdrive. Well, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Overdrive, our first ever pay-per-view right here on Wrestling Classic. And this is an accumulation of a lot of work from a lot of people. And right here tonight, we're going to see some action. We're going to see lots of matches, lots of title matches, and also a number one contenders match for the Wrestling Classic World Championship. And of course, that main event tonight between Nakamura and actually that man that you see on the right of the screen right there, our current Wrestling Classic pure champion, Johnny the Animal Wolf, as they go one-on-one for the World Championship. But right up next in our first contest of the evening is Youngblood taking on Johnny the Animal Wolf. And yes, he's got two matches right here tonight, Mr. Two Match Johnny the Animal Wolf. And he is defending his pure wrestling title against Youngblood. And that match is coming right up now.
The following contest is a submission match. It is for the Wrestling Classic Pure Championship.
the challenger from Atlanta, Georgia, weighing in at 263 pounds, Youngblood. And introducing the champion from St. Louis, Missouri, weighing in at 231 pounds. He is the Wrestling Classic Pure Champion.
Well, here we go then, folks. Welcome to Overdrive. Again, my name is Ambassador, and this is a great contest to open things up here tonight, here in Florida. Johnny the Animal Wolf with the acrobatics there against Youngblood, who became the number one contender. He had a number one contenders match, and he won that match, and he won the right to compete against Johnny the Animal Wolf here for the Pure Wrestling Championship here tonight on Overdrive. And we are sold out here in Tampa. It's a great atmosphere that we've got here tonight. And as you can see, Youngblood and Johnny the Animal Wolf opening things up. Now, if you're not really familiar with these matches and you're tuning in for the first time, these matches are of a duration of 15 minutes. So it's a 15-minute time limit. And it's only submissions that count. So, and you have to get more than one submission. You have to actually get two submissions within that time limit to win the match. So that's what Youngblood and John and the Animal Wolf are going to be doing here. And what's actually quite distinctive about this match is that Johnny the Animal Wolf is competing in two championship matches in one night. And it hasn't put him off in the slightest. Actually, if anything, it's encouraged him. It's made him even more confident, going from what I've seen in his promos and what he's, you know, the activity and the way he's been conducting himself backstage. It's made the guy even more determined. So as you can see, normally there we could have gone for a pinfall attempt, but Johnny the Animal Wolf knows that he's got to make Youngblood tap out, and he's got to make him tap out more than once. Youngblood now got a kind of a Texas cloverleaf move on here onto Johnny the Animal Wolf here, and he steps back across and he's pushed away by Johnny the Animal Wolf, and that was the first real attempt there at gaining a submission from either of these two so far in the contest. Now, I don't know how it happened, but as you can see from, there's an armbar attempt here from Johnny the Animal Wolf, but looking at Youngblood's face, he's been busted open. I don't know how on earth that happened there, whether he was caught in the face or whether there was a flailing arm or a flailing elbow or something. But, you know, again, when you're in the ring, it can be quite a dangerous place to be within the squared circle. But already Youngblood busted open for whatever reason. It wasn't apparently obvious what had happened there. So Johnny the Animal Wolf working on the arm, on the left arm of Youngblood. Wow, and this is a high risk, high flying maneuver from the champion. And now the ground and pound from Johnny the Animal Wolf. And I guess this could be a stoppage here. The referee could jump in and stop the match. That is one way to win a Pure Wrestling contest here in Wrestling Classic. You can certainly win from the knockout, from the stoppage. There's no way that the referee should allow a match to continue if he thinks that the grounded opponent is in danger of some kind or at risk of being seriously hurt there. Johnny the Animal Wolf now dumps Youngblood face first down onto the canvas. A huge forearm there from Youngblood. I thought he was going to set up that cloverleaf move again. Youngblood just then. Wait a minute. There's a submission from Youngblood. And he's got it locked in on Johnny the Animal Wolf here. And the referee's down checking with the champion whether he wants to give up here. He could quite easily give up, but look at the strength from Johnny the Animal Wolf as he powers his way out of it. And Youngblood making a mistake there, missing with the knee. And nice drop toe hold there by Johnny the Animal Wolf. As I say, a very good technical wrestler, being the champion. And of course, you've got to be very good technically to even get involved in these matches. And now, Johnny the Animal Wolf then cinching in his own submission move. And he pulls back. Look at the torque on that shoulder blade. And he taps out. Youngblood's tapped out there. But that's not the end of the match. That's not it. That's one submission now scored by Johnny the Animal Wolf. Now Wolf needs to stay on top of his opponent here. He's already got the one submission. He needs to continue now to try and get the second one in. A great move by Johnny the Animal Wolf. And again, there it is again. He's going for that same move in the hope that Youngblood's going to tap out. How much more can he take? That's it. The referee waves it away. And we ring the bell. And Johnny the Animal Wolf is still the Pure Wrestling Champion. Well, congratulations to Johnny the Animal Wolf for successfully defending the Pure Wrestling Championship right there in our opening contest on Overdrive. And what a show we have got here, ladies and gentlemen, for you. You're really looking forward to the rest of the show. We are as well. And I know that Johnny the Animal Wolf will now go backstage and prepare for the main event this evening when he takes on Nakamura for that World Championship. That and much, much more still to come, including a singles contest now. And this is a grudge match owing to what happened last week. We'll be right back. Well, this should be some match between Logan, the returning Logan King, and Preston Fuel, based on the fact that we had an interference last week where Logan King snuck up. Well, the stage, there was some kind of distraction, and Preston Fuel turned his back on his opponent temporarily, looking up at the stage, but Logan King wasn't there. And then Logan King appeared from nowhere. Nobody saw where he came from. Kicked Preston Fuel straight in the face and allowed Michael Winters to get the cover and win the match. And Preston Fuel was furious afterwards. And that has enabled now this match to be formed for this pay-per-view here between these two. We haven't seen Logan King for many weeks now. It's been, you know, a long time since we've seen him. Haven't seen very much of him at all. Preston Fuel lying down on the canvas here. And don't ask me how much respect there is between these two, because I don't know. But hanging onto the leg there, Logan King. And now King is gone up to the top here. Wait a minute. King all the way down. High flying, high risk maneuver from the top rope there. And a nice takedown from Logan King. King and Preston Fuel have never met in the ring before. And obviously we know what Preston Fuel is capable of. There really is no limit into how angry this man can get. He can get out of control. And when he does that, we really don't know what he is capable of. But there, Logan King again with another pinfall attempt here. And Preston Fuel escapes by getting his hand on the ropes there. Just escaping with the... Just literally fingertips away there, Logan King, from the victory. And now this is where Preston Fuel is at his most dangerous, as he dumps him on the back of the head there, the back of his neck. Actually, that's what it looked like to me. We've seen Preston Fuel literally drop-kicking people from one end of the ring to the other. Double underhook takes Logan King over there. And now Preston Fuel just stomping away at Logan King. Again, very close to the rope. Wait a minute, two! And again, that's what I thought. I thought that the positioning of Logan King there, maybe it's just a little bit of a lack of experience, really, from Logan King. But he's pinning Preston Fuel. But each time, Preston Fuel and his experience in terms of his ring awareness, reaching out for that bottom rope, it's good to know where you are in the ring when you can get out of it. If there's no escape, you know, the ropes are going to be your saviour. Wait a minute. Preston Fuel dumps him down. And that could be it now. Fuel just dumping Logan King right onto the back of the head there. DDT from King. And King takes a risk and he does not make it pay. And that could be a fatal mistake when you get in there with Preston Fuel with the knee. German suplex right onto the back of the head there. That could be it now. Preston Fuel going for the cover here. Referee down. One, two, and Logan King kicks out of it. My God, how the hell did he do it? And now Fuel has tied him up. There's no way he's going to get out of that, and there's no way he can reach for the ropes. King in trouble here. In a lot of trouble in this submission move by Preston Fuel. What a match we're seeing between these two, back and forth, the action. Preston Fuel gives Logan King the thumbs down. And I don't know what that signifies. That could be the end of the match if Logan King can't get to his feet. Preston Fuel with the thumbs down. I mean, what does this mean? Oof! Back of the head into the turnbuckle there as Preston Fuel went down. And a lot of high-flying moves here. And King now with a pinfall attempt on Preston Fuel. And Logan King has picked up the 1-2-3.
Here is your winner, the real deal, Logan King.
We'll be right back.
So here we go then, it's triple threat action coming up here right now on Overdrive. Women's Championship on the line here, so a lot at stake between Lilith, Amy and Minerva. Of course, all of these three ladies are partnered or associated with other wrestling classic superstars. Lilith and Purgatory, of course, we've seen them many times before tagging together. And then you've got Amy and Frank, and of course Bulldozer and Minerva, who we've seen in mixed tag team action leading up to this match, actually. And we decided to throw it all together. Why don't we just throw everybody in the mix? We've seen all the mixed tag action. Why don't we just have these three ladies in the ring together for the vacant Wrestling Classic Women's Championship? And that is what we're going to witness right here today. Minerva there nicely hanging on to the pin there. That was a pretty good move by her. Lilith taking advantage though, interfering, and a powerbomb down by Lilith. Just dragging Minerva across the ring there. Cover by Lilith. Could be over very, very quickly as Minerva kicks out of it. Oh, what a drop kick by Minerva. What the hell has Bulldozer been doing with Minerva? Has he been training her to do things like that? I mean, my God, she's just leapt across there, three quarters of the way across this 16 by 16 feet ring. And that takes some doing, believe me. Now, Amy celebrating, turning her back on her opponents here. Not a good idea. And Lilith has had enough. She's rolled to the outside. Cover by Amy this time. Amy with a cover, but Minerva kicks out after one. Wait a minute, this could be some kind of pump handle. Slam by Lilith, just slamming Amy down on the canvas. Is she going to get the three? No. Amy kicks out. In the meantime, Minerva goes in for a kick, but Amy catches it on the way in. At the moment, the strongest person in there appears to be Lilith, with the powerful moves, the lifting moves that she uses and those power slams. Now she's turning Minerva around. Face first goes Minerva. They're both down now. Lilith with a cover. This could be the three here. And no! 2.5. That was very, very, very close. Lilith could have been the women's champion there. Oh, that was so close. I think Amy was just standing there, kind of watching on there. Another slam by Lilith. Now Lilith going up to the top here whilst Minerva is on the outside. Lilith, high risk maneuver here, beckoning Amy to get up here from the canvas and down. Oh, I think Amy moved out of the way. Now Amy working on the arm of Lilith. Amy with the cover here. One, and no, that looked like Lilith was going to interfere with the count there. And now Minerva opening up on a nice European uppercut there on Amy. Look at Lilith. Oh, that looked like a little bit of a low blow, but the referee didn't see it. Blocked there, and coming back now, Minerva. Minerva certainly holding her own in that ring. He's not as experienced as the other two. Cover by Minerva, but Amy was in there to break the count there. Look at Amy. Looks like she's setting something up here. Minerva turns round. Amy poised. Takes Minerva down. Cover for the title. One, two, three. That's it, Amy. It's the new women's champion.
Here is your winner and new wrestling classic women's champion, the Psycho.
So here we go then. It's Frank Knight and Alex the Perfect Storm. Alex Storm going one-on-one for the All-Star Fighting Championship, the result of the tournament that's been taking place these past several weeks here in Wrestling Classic on Venom, which is our flagship televised show. And I have to say that really, these two deserve to be the two number one contenders. They've worked really, really hard to get to this stage, the finals. And Frank has just seen Amy win the Women's Championship in our last match in that triple threat with Lilith and Minerva. And Frank is going to be looking to also gain some gold for himself here tonight in this contest. Both of these guys are sporting different attire for the pay-per-view right here in Tampa, Florida. And I have to say, everybody's looking good and everything's good backstage. There's a great sort of, there's a lot of momentum, a lot of motivation, a lot of heat backstage coming up to these matches, and some of the people that have already been involved in matches here already tonight as Frank goes for the cover. And you can see Frank Knight there taking an elbow from the Perfect Storm, Alex Storm, and Storm takes him from back and down with that German suplex. What a great move there, that acrobatical way of getting into that move to start with. We've seen Alex Storm in the pure wrestling division as well. This guy, believe me folks, is multi-talented. Cover here by the Perfect Storm, gets the two, and just Frank Knight kicks out on two. That was close. Now Alex Storm onto the top rope here, but look at the way. Oh! Almost thought that Frank Knight was going to move out of the way, but Alex Storm with the cover, he lands it right onto the back of Frank Knight here. But again, the left shoulder comes up from Frank Knight, and then he stays in the match. And Alex Storm looks at the referee as if to say, what else do I need to do to keep this man down? You know, Frank Knight has certainly got some resilience, and he keeps kicking out of these moves. Yeah. Look at that stamp on the arm there by Alex Storm. I mean, he's going to go to any length to get the job done here. Frank Knight in with the cover. Oh, and the left shoulder comes up from Alex Storm. That was a close call. Almost a new champion right there. Frank Knight goes in for the cover again. Gets the two, three. And it is Frank Knight that is the new All-Star Fighting Champion. Well, what a match between those two then, and the Perfect Storm. It could have gone either way, really. The Perfect Storm, Alex Storm, started off with the upper hand, but then Frank Knight came back into it, and now Frank is the All-Star Fighting Champion, and Amy is the Women's Champion. Together, they have gold between the pair of them. What a team they are going to make as the Overdrive continues with a fatal four-way match. This match is a number one contenders match for the Wrestling Classic World Championship. Well, this should be some match here between these four guys who are arguably some of the best Wrestling Classic superstars that we have here in Wrestling Classic. And there's a lot at stake being a number one contenders match. Anyone, wait a minute, which one of the two is this going to be? If you get a pinfall here, who would win it? Which pinfall was he counting, the referee? I think he was counting Purgatory and Tech there, but Asher had the pinfall on Michael Winners. So I don't know which one of the two that he was counting, but it's hell, you can count with both hands, referee. Count both hands. One, two, three. Well, this fatal four-way number one contenders match. So the winner of this contest will face the world champion at a date to be determined. And it won't be too long. It certainly won't be, it may not be next week on Venom, but certainly possibly the week after this world championship match, because we've got a match coming right off after this one in the main event. But these four guys just literally are going to leave everything in the ring here, really, to be honest, in their attempts to become the number one contender. And you can see just how much Michael Winners wants this match, in this number one contenders match. Of course, the Ripper, Asher Callahan there, jumping over the top rope. And look at how Tech comes running in, slides back in and clotheslines Michael Winners out there, takes him out. Tech is one very, very dangerous individual, I have to say. He never takes that mask off. It doesn't matter whether he's backstage, or whether he's in the ring, or whether he's driving. I've seen him pulling up in his car with the mask on. Goodness knows what the public think when he's driving with that mask on. I'm not sure whether he's filmed himself on social media when he stops next to somebody at a red light and turns to look at them with his mask on. He's going to frighten the life out of anybody. Slingshot there over the top rope by Purgatory, and the close-up shot of Purgatory getting in the ring, and those marks, those, you know, life-changing scars on his face. And it just, you know, where on earth have all those scars come from? Those battle wars from previous matches, wrestling. It might not have even been a wrestling match. It could have been something else. Might have been another scarring for life. You know. Double DDT by Tech, and Michael Winners takes out Callahan, leaving Tech in the ring with Michael Winters here. Purgatory watches as Tech just works over Michael Winners and then chooses his moment to pounce. And is this the moment that he's got Tech now? Up now, he brings him right up. All the strength and power bombs him down. And he's covering Tech here. Wait a minute, referee's down. Two, three, and Purgatory is the number one contender. Well, what a match, and Purgatory is now the official number one contender for the Wrestling Classic World Championship. And who's going to win now? As we see, it's main event time, and it's Johnny the Animal Wolf and Nakamura who will be facing each other for this Wrestling Classic World Heavyweight Championship right here in Tampa, Florida. It's time for our main event at Overdrive. Let's get down to ringside.
The following champion versus champion contest is scheduled for one fall and is for the Wrestling Classic World Championship. Introducing the champion from Kyoto, Japan, weighing in at 214 pounds.
Well, here we go, ladies and gentlemen, and the time has come to find out who is the best Wrestling Classic superstar there is. Is it Nakamura, the champion there, looking at his belt, handing it over to the referee, or is it going to be Johnny the Animal Wolf, who has already proven himself here time and time again that he is the best pure wrestling wrestler, the best technical wrestler here in Wrestling Classic already tonight by beating Youngblood. And now Johnny the Animal Wolf now is going to attempt to prove to everybody that he is the best here in Wrestling Classic. As you can see, Nakamura and Johnny the Animal Wolf have prepared attires for the pay-per-view, looking good. And this sold-out crowd here in Tampa, Florida, they are standing up on their feet here. They've enjoyed the whole thing, the whole event, the whole day here. Even the pre-shows and even the, leading up to the show and all the entertainment that we had in the ring leading up to this wrestling extravaganza here today. And you can see, oh, look at that DDT right on the edge of the apron there from Johnny the Animal Wolf. And that is going to leave a mark, I can tell you. The hardest part of the ring. And these two guys are just going at it on the outside now. You can see Nakamura laying in the kicks and the punches, and Johnny the Animal Wolf is soaking it all up, giving as much as he gets here on the outside. And into the steps goes Nakamura. And Johnny the Animal Wolf gets into the ring. And almost to the count of 10, the referee is Nakamura slides back in. Nice drop kick off the rope there by Johnny Wolf. Cover now. Why not? Go for the cover. Gets the two, and the champion kicks out of it. I mean, yeah, take the opportunities that you get. Every opportunity that you get, you should cover your opponent. You never know. You never know what impact a single move is going to have on your opponent. Now Nakamura with John the Animal Wolf up, and a right hand straight in the face from Nakamura. Swinging knee. That could be it there. That could be enough to get the victory. Is he going to retain the championship? No, Johnny the Animal Wolf kicks out of it. Now Nakamura with the left knee into the face. Cover by the champion. One, two, and again, just hanging in there. The left shoulder from Johnny the Animal Wolf comes up with the shoulder, and Nakamura and keeps himself in the match. Nakamura now wants to retain the championship. And each wrestler now just firing moves at the other one and then pinning them, hoping that that is going to get the job done. Both of these guys can pretty much do anything. High-flying moves, technical, it really doesn't matter. Crowd just cheering away here as Johnny the Animal Wolf makes his way to the feet there. This mixed martial arts specialist Nakamura with all these kicks. Look at the way he's fighting with shadows there. Even got time to do that in this world championship match. Breaking the hold there in a DDT counter by Johnny the Animal Wolf there. Roll up. That could get the job done. One, two, and kicks out. Johnny the Animal Wolf kicks out of it. Well, Nakamura is trying anything he possibly can to get the job done here. Each time he pins him, two. And again, the left shoulder just off the canvas. Nakamura saying that was three. Shoulder came up at two there. Now the champion trying to finish off Johnny the Animal Wolf gets a two, and again, this time it's the right shoulder that comes up. God, the resilience and the pure wrestling champion, and you would expect that from another champion here in Wrestling Classic. My God, Nakamura all but finishing off Johnny the Animal Wolf as Johnny moves out of the way, comes back with a kick of his own. Wait a minute, drop kick from Johnny the Animal Wolf. And Johnny the Animal Wolf has come back into the match here. Folding the arms up. Down he takes him. Hangs on to this. Cut pinfall. One. Two. And no. No, 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 no. What a match between these two in our main event here on Overdrive. Johnny the Animal Wolf. We saw that match earlier on to retain the pure wrestling title. That's two. No. Still, the world champion stays in the match with the shoulder coming up off the canvas. And look at the ground and pound now from the pure wrestling champion as he just elbows and punches Nakamura now while he's grounded on the canvas. And how much more can Nakamura take here, the world champion? Nakamura, wow, what a match. Honestly, I thought this match would have been over by now, but the amount of times both of these guys have kicked out of holds and moves, it's unbelievable. Wait a minute, no, not again! The second time, that DDT onto the outside of the edge of the apron, and Johnny the Animal Wolf is absolutely determined to defeat Nakamura. There's no two ways about that now. We can clearly see the level of aggression has gone up here. The notch has been turned up. The heat is high. I'm telling you now, in this ring. Mistake there by Johnny the Animal Wolf. And again, it's just counter move after counter move. Both wrestlers just really cancelling each other out on the ground and pound now by Nakamura. As Johnny the Animal Wolf covering up here, trying to take these blows as they come in. And Nakamura with that knee. Is that gonna be enough? That's the 1-2-3, and Nakamura is still world champion. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that brings us to the end of pay-per-view, our Overdrive pay-per-view. What a main event. Nakamura is still the Wrestling Classic World Champion, but congratulations and well done to all of our Wrestling Classic superstars involved in this pay-per-view for all of the work that you put into it and all the work you continue to do to make this product a success. My name's Ambassador. Thanks for tuning in. We'll see you next weekend for Venom. Until then, thank you and good night.